Mary asks, my sister had a pool party yesterday and the kids were playing rough and one girl hit her head hard on the side of the pool. It was an accident, but my sister is worried she'd be sued because the adults there were drinking. Please advise. Right. What do you tell Mary here?
Yeah, well, I mean, should they be concerned? Well, yes. I mean, is there potential exposure in a situation like that? Yes, there is. Will something come out of that? No, most likely not. But I mean, you and I, we both grew up in neighborhoods where, at least I did, where we had a lot of kids. We had pool parties. We bunch of kids roughhousing in the pool and on the trampoline and all of that. And so things happen, stuff happens, as they say. But if the kids are not being watched, and I don't know how old these kids are, but I mean, if they're 17, 18 years old, that's one thing. If they're 5, 6, 7 years old and they're roughhousing and the parents are, at the margarita machine, that's a whole different story. And so, the main thing to remember, and I don't, probably nothing will come out of this, and I'm not, saying that there should be, but the thing to remember, if you're going to have a party or have any kind of gathering at your house, just make sure you do the right thing. And so if you have a bunch of 5, 6, 7-year-olds that's going to be running around, and we all know how, kids are at that age, just sit there and talk to all the adults and then not mind the kids. And if you do, then there can be, a lack of negligence, in the other word, as far as watching the kids and, negligent supervision and things of that nature, and you don't want that. So if you're going to have kids at that age running around, jumping in pools, jumping on the trampoline, you need to be coherent, not drinking, and making sure everybody's okay.
And so if they were going to come after you as the property owner, would they sue your homeowner's policy? Would you be covered that way? Could they come after you after your personal assets? Would that be covered by an umbrella policy? How would you, what parties would be sued in that scenario?
All the above. Basically, they're sue you. They're going to name you because in the state of Alabama, let's say you have State Farm insurance. They can't name State Farm in the state of Alabama. They're going to name you. Now, if you have State Farm homeowners insurance, that's who's going to be paying your lawyer fees and indemnifying you if there's some type of a settlement or judgment. But if I was representing a kid that was in a situation like that, you're going to name everybody. You're going to name the homeowner. You're going to name, whoever you can, just to see who the guilty party was. And if some parties wind up not being in it, if they showed that they were not negligent, then a good lawyer is going to let that person out. My firm, we had a case last week where we identified that a company that we had sued in a maritime accident didn't have anything to do with it, and we let them out at depositions. And so a good lawyer, a good law firm, they're not going to waste someone's time and effort on something that they don't belong in.